Ooh. That's gonna wave at you, glowing red.
What are you waiting for, huh?
Oh, hello there. It's Russ from Aussie Mushroom Supplies again. And we're gonna do an agar transfer. So what we wanna do is, we've got an agar plate here. We wanna cut a little cutting from the leading edge and transfer it onto our other agar plate. Just obviously keep our culture young and fresh. You can store cultures in test tubes and cryogenic freezers and stuff like that. You gotta make sure they don't get too old as they start to degrade over time. We're working in front of a laminar flow hood today. You've gotta work in a fully sterile airflow, otherwise other spores and things will land the agar plates and outcompete your mushrooms. So you gotta do this in a very, very clean way. So sorry about the noise, guys, but let's get into it. We've got our tool sterilizer over here. That's gonna sterilize our scalpel. Gets to about 500 degrees, so for the love of God, don't put your finger in there. We wanna sterilize our scalpel before we use it. It only takes sort of 3 or 4 seconds to get it really hot, and then we'll cool it down in our receiving agar plate before we cut the mycelium, otherwise it's gonna damage it from the heat. Always working from the back, and you wanna cut on the leading edge in a little square. Working from behind, putting it in your new agar plate. Obviously you need to sterilize your tool again between transfers in case anything lands on your scalpel when you're moving around. Again, make sure you cool down your scalpel between transfers. Cut out a little square from your leading edge. Working from the back, opening like from the front. Putting your transfer on there. One of the most important things with your agar plates is sealing them. So we've got laboratory parafilm here. You gotta take off the paper, easier than it looks. You wanna take off the paper side, obviously without touching that inner side. We fold it over. And then put that on the side of your agar plate and seal your agar plate. Remember, always trying to keep behind your agar plate so nothing risks coming off you to land in it. This is a breathable tape as your mycelium needs to be able to breathe while it grows. Oh geez. Again, opening towards the filter. We fold it over. Keeping your agar plate closed. Over the next week, this transfer should grow out from the center to the outside. When it's about sort of 80% grown, you wanna put it in the fridge to stop it growing. Make sure every month or two you do new transfers just to keep your cultures young and fresh. Keep an eye on that they're growing properly and you've got no troubles.
Tips for doing agar transfers. Do your work in front of a laminar flow hood. Otherwise, use a still air box at an absolute minimum. Anything flying around your room that lands on your agar will grow and outcompete your mushrooms. So agar work must be done in a very sterile environment. Can also use, example, your bathroom. If you fully disinfect it, floor to ceiling, shut the door for a few hours so everything in the air settles, and then in freshly clean clothes, slide in and do your work very quickly and try and keep your lid covering your agar plate and work through a crack in the side. You will have more contamination problems this way, but it's a good way to start. Number two, always work from behind the agar plate, out of your sterile airflow from your flow hood. This way, anything that might be on your hands can't fly off and land in your sterile agar plates. Number three, always take your cuttings from the leading edge of the transfer away from any problems you might have. Number four, keep your cultures running regularly. If you leave them for too long, they do degrade over time in the fridge, so make sure you refreshen your cultures regularly for storage longer than 2 months. Use a master tube. Master tubes will last 1 to 2 years, depending on your culture. Agar is the easiest way to know what you're growing is clean, so it's a very good method to grow mushrooms. Number five. What is number five? I need number five. Number five. Incubate your agar plates around 20 degrees. Once they're about 80% colonized, then put them into storage. Number six. Make sure the culture you're storing is able to go in the fridge. Some types like pink oyster, which are a warmer summer mushroom, they need to be stored around 10 degrees. They also degrade a lot quicker, so you need to remake your plates and tubes a lot more regularly. Number 7, probably the most important one. Wear a face mask, wear a hairnet and gloves, and make sure you clean your bench down with isopropyl just before you work, and clean your hands. Whenever you touch anything that's not your work, re-isopropyl your hands. This is the most common place people get contaminations in their work from, is yourself. Thanks for watching, we'll see you next time.
Yeah. Thanks for watching. If there's anything else you want to learn, drop us a comment down below. Don't forget to smash that bell, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you later.
And don't forget to smash that bell over there.
Or is it over there? Is it there? There? Where's that bell?